When you turn the machine on, you will be brought to a straight stitch and the last fabric that you had selected within the sewing advisor. That's this area down below. And we'll go into that in more detail and throughout the videos as we go. But if you don't know which fabric you'll be working on, I would recommend touching the B setting, which is for woven medium. And that way, everything's kind of back to normal here. But we're going to talk about selecting stitches because there's a couple things and ways to go about doing it. So what we want to do is we can come over here to the stitch menu. These are like little tabs we can go between. This is the sewing information. So we have everything from stitch length, needle positions, tension, free motion setting, what needle to use for the fabric we've picked, but we've also got how to get to our other stitches. When we touch here, we notice that we have stitches 1 through 12. All right, as you pick them, this area will change and we'll recommend also a presser foot, which I love that it always kind of helps me. Now, on the utility stitches, there is more than one screen of utility stitches. I'm going to show you something that we'll talk about again throughout all of our videos is if there is a function with a little kind of lower arrow in the bottom right corner, that means you can touch and hold it. Touch and hold for like 2 seconds. Notice what pops up. This is the rest of the stitches to get to it. Here's another example of that little arrow in the bottom corner. That's for removing or trashing something, deleting something. If you just touch it once, it deletes one item. But if you touch and hold it, it will be like, would you like to delete all? And there'll be a little message and it'll pop up and you'll say yes or no. Okay, so now when you take a look at our utility stitches in our menu A, you'll notice that right here there's three little bubbles. The first bubble is highlighted, so if you touch it again, you have the next 12 stitches. Stitch 13 through 24. Again, when I select one, it will then be picked. And then if I want to come back to those little area of stitches, we can just touch and hold up here on the stitch menu and you can rotate through. So if we jump down here to the B menu, which are for satin stitches, and notice there's four bubbles here. One, two, or I should say two, menu three, menu four. So 38 stitches. So all of them usually have some type of multiple pages in each of those areas, and when you pick one, it's ready to stitch. You can also pick your stitches if you go over here to kind of the start menu. The start menu will take you down to your stitch menu, your alphabets, your programming of the memory, your opening, and also your set menu where the tools are hanging out. And those we'll go into in more depth. So as you pick stitches, so right now I'm on menu C. I'm all the way down into stitch number 25. What's the fastest way to get back to a straight stitch? So you could do a couple things. You can touch and hold. You can come back to A, and you can pick a stitch. That was quite a few touches. Here is a faster way. So here, let me just pull up a random decorative stitch. Okay, we're over here. Heirloom stitches. Ooh, menu C. I want to go back to a straight stitch. If you come down here to our sewing advisor, technique number one is a seam. That is a straight stitch. I'm back to a straight stitch. So, and then whatever fabric you've selected, that will indicate what stitch length will be selected for starting out, which you could of course change, but if you picked a different fabric, it would change the stitch length for you. That's why I always say menu or fabric B is a woven medium. Wow. All right. Woven medium fabric. Seam easy to get to. And of course, if you turn your machine off and on, that will also bring you back to a straight stitch.